time in Thafnir has certainly been eventful. In my opinion, carrying out Vitra's request and assaulting the Tower of Zot should be our highest priority.
I agree. While I still have questions concerning the Forum and their grand undertaking, we have all but exhausted our avenues of investigation. Simply pressing them any harder on the subject will almost certainly result in our expulsion. Therefore, I suggest we explore the Ethereal Sea Connection by way of a letter to Master Matoya, then make our way to Thavnir.
I wonder, even with the protection these talismans afford us, what can we hope to achieve once inside the tower? According to Orenvold and Fordola's report, they were unable to free the Emolja. Worse, their attempts triggered the tower's defenses, which led to a summoning of Lunar Efreet.
What does it tell us that the Spires even have such defenses? Simply pulling a prisoner from the wall is fatal, thus the direct approach is doomed to failure from the outset. Any further measures to dissuade such actions seem unnecessary. Unless, of course, there is a way to free the prisoners without killing them, then it stands to reason that any intruders will be met with overwhelming force.
The towers appeared throughout the world in but the twinkling of an eye. 'Twas by magical means these structures were raised, I surmise. A spire thus conjured must needs be maintained. And I suspect an arcane catalyst, some manner of core, doth lie hidden within. Destroy the core, and the tower ceaseth to be, thus liberating the captives without harm.
So we can hope, and I would prefer to enter the tower with a working theory than with no plan at all.
Assuming Ishtola's reasoning is correct, the chances of the defenses remaining dormant are small to none. Any primals will have to be dealt with, and defeating one will likely only lead to the summoning of another. Our every victory will only compound the prisoner's suffering.
May we not then divide our forces? Those proficient in healing will focus on sustaining the captives. That duty can be covered by Uriange, Kryl, Yostola, and myself. The remaining Scions will proceed with the search for the core. Admittedly, this strategy puts both parties at greater risk, but it should bolster our chances of saving the Arcosodal by a considerable margin. That she does. But I think Alize herself would assert that she's at her best when she's charging onto the breach. And from what I recall from the Grand Cosmos, there's a spring in her step when she fights by your side.
Ye gods, will you never let me hear the end of that? Rest assured that I will do what is asked of me, regardless of who I happen to be standing next to at any given time.
It seems we have a plan. All that remains is to carry it out. I will inform Rad-Zit-Han of our movements, so let us make our preparations and regroup near the tower.
The military post in what's left of the Hamsa hatchery should serve as a convenient staging.
That sounds perfect. And remember, the experimental etherite at the confluence is there for those who need it, so there's no excuse for being late.
Let's give it our all!
My turn!
guard! Let's give them a show!
Yeah. cannot stop us!
Stop us!
mine! You cannot stop us!
armor shown! Is everyone all right?
We fortified the captives with what magics we could. Have the defenses been disabled? All appears quiet for the moment.
Lower floors were disturbing enough, but this place feels wrong. The ether is heavy and thick, like wading through a quagmire.
I believe we stand in the tower's beating heart. What sayest thou, Stola?
I see it. Ether siphoned from the land runs up through the spire, flowing to a single point. This is the core we seek. Yet something is off. As large as this structure is, it siphons far more ether than is required to sustain it. It is as if the core is feeding on the energy, consuming it. I need to take a closer look. Curious. There is something there, embedded inside the core. A man's limb.
This is what we came to destroy?
Yes, if you would be so kind.
And that should be the end of it.
now!
My theory that the tower might come crashing down following the core's destruction doth appear to be correct.
Bully for you! And how are we supposed to survive the fall?
What if the prisoners below?
The floor beneath our very feet dissolves. Brace yourselves!
I pray I'm not too late.
What happened? Where are we?
By my reckoning, we're still on the island where the tower stood. But 'tis as if it never existed. Hardly a scratch. But how?
Raha wove a levitation spell at the last moment. Large enough to catch everyone, it would seem.
That explains the lack of obvious injuries.
The expenditure of so much ether has taken its toll. He will need plenty of rest, but should otherwise be none the worse for wear.
Then the immediate problem is what to do with our new friends here. They'll be much changed for their time in the tower. Even if their bodies are intact, I doubt we could say the same for their minds.
Angelo and I will take care of that.
I have every faith in you, Alizé, but there are just too many for you to treat alone.
We'll send at once to Eorzea for more porksies, and call on the local mages to lend a hand.
Hail, Scions! We were watching the tower when it simply disappeared. What happened here?
The threat is banished, and thy people delivered. They are, however, in need of treatment, and we of a secure locale and helping hands to assist us in its provision.
You shall have all this and more. Come, let us convey these unfortunate souls to the city.